All right, boys, we're talking bows today, and the newest bow brought to us in Crimson Days is called the Vow. It is a lightweight frame bow present in the energy slot, so for some of those that want to rock something like Last Word with this bow, you can do that. The biggest selling point to this is that it comes fully masterwork and a pretty decent static roll, as well as a draw time of 600, which I believe is the lowest you can actually get on a bow, and by the way, the lower the number, the faster. So first up, let's hit these perks. Intrinsically, again guys, this is a lightweight frame bow. It draws quickly, you move faster while this weapon is equipped, and our string perk here is polymer string, which slightly increases our accuracy and gives us a slightly faster draw time. It also comes with natural fletching, but the two traits here, which really piqued our interest, is rapid hit and archer's tempo. Now, rapid hit temporarily increases stability with each precision hit. Probably one of the best perks in the game, guys. Like, if I had to rank perks, this is up there as one of, like, the top perks you can get on any of your weapons. Now, archer's tempo, draw time decrease after every precision hit. Now, how much does it decrease? Not by a whole lot, guys. Matter of fact, when testing this, it really only reduces your draw time by 6 frames, which is such a small value in terms of milliseconds. Is it gonna make that big of a difference? On lightweight frame bows, not really. I don't know how archer's tempo works with everyone. I don't know if it's a flat 6-frame reduction amongst all bows. It is possible that there could be a draw time floor, as in we can't go lower than say something like 575 or 550. I'm just throwing out some numerical values. I don't know what the value would be in terms of draw time. Just know that the reduction there is not that noticeable. Now, the masterwork you see at play today is a targeting adjuster mod. Obviously, helps out with snagging those crit shots, and considering that this is a lightweight frame bow, double body shots will not get you a kill. You're gonna have to hit at least 1 crit and 1 body, considering that it hits 138 per crit and 86 per body. Now, the mods here is something that I get kinda annoyed about. I would prefer a quick access sling to be present over any other mod, especially if you're rocking something like Last Word. To get the quick swap to Last Word to finish opponents off would be a pretty nasty combination. Unfortunately, you cannot apply quick access sling. Now, another one you can look into is maybe radar booster, or maybe the mod that actually returns your radar faster after aiming down sights. There's a number of things. You could even go something like knucklehead radar, radar booster. That way, when you aim down sights, you still have your radar and you're getting that extension. Some different options there in terms of builds. The build that I found that worked well for me today was actually Lucky Pants, Last Word, and the Vow. Having the faster ready speed to Last Word, including that increased accuracy when swapping to it, was a great follow-up choice after landing a crit with the Vow. Now, is the Vow a bow worth using in something like Crucible? To me, guys, not really. But I understand that my playstyle is different from a lot of people. There are some people out there that lives and breathes these lightweight bows. For me, guys, I still prefer Le Monarch, Subtle Calamity. Sure, those bows have a longer draw time, but they have substantially more accuracy. And they also allow you to cheese a lot of things. You wanna rock empowering rifts and get one hit bow kills? Go right ahead. You can't really pull those things off with lightweight bows. They're kinda in an awkward situation. Now, comparing this bow to say other bows, yes, the Vow is a superior bow to other lightweight bows. It has better aim assist. It has very good stability. It comes with a good static roll. Its accuracy is not the best, but it ties with some of the best at 54. So needless to say, guys, the Vow is not a terrible bow. I think the most punishing thing about this bow is that it's just in an archetype that I am not a fan of. Despite it having a much faster draw time than many of our other bows, its inconsistency at times just doesn't make up for it. Well, guys, that is the Vow bow. Try it for yourself. Shax is selling it for 100 hearts. Really, the best way to get all the hearts is just to do the Nightfall with another person. I think 2-man Nightfall rewards 75 hearts, which is a fair amount. And the rest you can get by just doing a couple bounties. Now, before I let you guys go, shout out to our pledges over on Patreon. My God, man, we jumped up like 20-something pledges yesterday. So much love to every one of you guys. Well, fellas and ladies, thank you all for coming and watching. And as always,
slap that like button like your mama told you right.